look, wake up
to yourselves.
I've got nothing against mothers, but we're not talking about mothers, for Christ's sake. We're talking about that stupid little
look,
bitch,
Chrissy. Look, she's pregnant. That's the same as being a mother.
And what sort of mother is she going to be, you drongos? Now, look, work it out for yourselves. She took that stuff to make herself sick, right?
Yeah, so?
So she was trying to get rid of the kid, right?
Well, yeah, suppose so.
So what kind of a mother's that going to make her?
Not too good, I suppose.
Right, so an abortion's the best thing all round, especially for the poor bloody kid.
Now, just a minute. Don't you think any of that gives you the right to thump her? She might be the worst mother God ever put on the earth, but the baby's got the right to a chance.
A chance? Now, what kind of a chance is it going to have in a dump like this?
Oh. Or could be adopted out, anything.
Adopted out? Who to? One of us? Oh, now, come on, Pat. I love kids as much as you do. And I'm a sucker for babies. Honest, I am. Oh, all right. If you can actually talk her into having the kid, I promise I'll lay off.
I find it real hard talking to people. You know, bigwigs and that.
Can't be that bad.
Well, have you ever been before the parole board?
Hardly. I've never been inside before.
No. Oh, well, you get all nervous and all your palms get sweaty.
Yeah. Feeling a bit that way about my trial.
Hmm. Yeah. That'd be worse, I reckon.
I'm sure I'll get off, though. I mean, they'd hardly jail you for what I did.
You wouldn't reckon.
And you'll already be out, so we'll be able to see each other.
Oh, would you come to this place at Karen's and live there?
Oh, I don't know, Jaw. I might go back to boarding school.
Oh.
You see, I'd like to go to university sometime, and that means I have to do my HSC first.
Oh, Karen went to uni. She's real brainy too.
I'm not brainy.
Oh, yes, you are. Karen did her course from here. She was always sitting around here reading and that. But I'm a real dumb bum.
Oh.
Wouldn't it be terrific if Chrissy did have a baby? Little child toddling around the joint. Motherhood's a wonderful thing.
Yeah.
Now, what would you know? How many kids have you had? Motherhood's plain hard work.
Yeah, so hard that they end up running out on their bloody kids. Well, none of you know what it's like, do you?
Now, look what you've done.
What?
Upsetting her like that.
Oh, give us a break. That's got nothing to do with me. She's just upset about her parole, that's all.
That's what you say.
I knew I should have stayed in bed this morning.
You know, O'Connell, you're going to have to curb this passion for being with kids. What are you up to?
Well,
You wouldn't by any chance be trying to see Chrissy Latham, would you?
Well, yes, Mr. Fletcher. You see, I reckon if Chrissy keeps going the way she is, she's headed for big trouble.
Yeah, well, so are you, if you get caught in an area you're not supposed to be in.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, perfectly.
So you reckon I should do me Errol Flynn impersonation, eh? Swing off the lights, up on the desk and say, me name's Captain Blood, and if I don't get a free pardon for me
I
and me crew...
I wouldn't go that far.
Yeah. Errol Flynn got killed at the end of most of his films.
Yeah, but he was the hero, wasn't he?
Oh, first thing I'm going to do is buy a nice pair of those high-heel boots.
Why? So you can trip over and break your neck.
Oh, how'd you go, love? Did you see her?
No, Jim Fletcher caught me.
Oh.
Oh, at least he's not going to report me.
What?
Blimey.
That's a turn-up.
Your trouble is, Pat, you're too busy looking after everyone else's problems instead of looking after your own. Like working out how to get to see that son of yours.
Now, don't you start.
Don't you start. I've had about a belly full of you for one day, Lizzie, so shut up and keep your mouth shut for a change. Now, have any of you, by any chance, seen into the maternity wing?
Well,
I have. And I mean seen. If you could get into the maternity wing, there's this particular window. Looks out over the garden. At least you'd have a chance to see this boy of yours.
But how would I get in? I mean, the screws are watching Chrissy like hawks. I'd never get past them.
You leave Chrissy to me.
Now, I'm not going to have anything to do with bullying her anymore.
Look, I promise you I wouldn't hurt her. Now, if my word's not good enough for you, you can forget it.
I'm sorry. Really.
Look, I've got a plan.
little temper of yours.
Oh, lay off me, old bag.
There's no need to go too far.
What is this going on?
Oh, it's Dora, Mrs. Barry. She's having one of her turns.
Oh, it's all right, Doreen.
Oh. What would you know?
What is wrong with her?
She has to go in front of the parole board. Anyone would think she's getting the electric chair. She's been like this all night.
Oh. Will you stop?
You know what she's like.
Oh, stay off me, old battle axe.
Oh, I'll go now in a minute.
Don't you stop it, Edison. Help me, you two.
Don't hurt her, Bea. Don't hurt her.
Oh, I'm not hurting her, am I, Chrissy?
I'm not going to either. Just as long as you do as you're told.
Now, are you gonna do as you're told, Chrissy?
Please.
Everything seems to be under control.
Yeah, I don't think we'll have any problems.
Good.
Aren't you going to stay with me then?
Why? Are you afraid of something?
Nah, of course not.
Well, that's just as well. Because I've got better things to do than to run around after you.
Wonder how poor old Dora's going.
I should be right, I reckon.
But I hope she doesn't say anything stupid.
Well, she shouldn't. She was pretty heavily sedated.
Yeah, they probably think they're talking to a zombie. Mind you, even awake, she's not all that bright.
Oh, that's not fair.
All right, O'Connell.
Hmm? Oh, yeah.
You look a bit pale to me.
No, I'm fine, really.
Perhaps you'd better go and see Dr. Miller.
No, I'll be all right.
Well, I don't think you will be. Come on, I'll take you myself.
Oh, no. I mean, thanks, but... If you reckon I ought to go, then I'll go.
I do.
Oh, I'll be all right. Thanks all the same.
Well, that makes a change from the usual attacks of hypochondria.
I hope you wasn't meaning me. It's lucky for you we haven't got a union, otherwise we'd all be out on strike.
Just get on with it, Lizzie.
Sorry.
Yeah. Now everything's all right. You know which window it is?
Yes.
Now just you remember, if you get caught, I had nothing to do with it. You're on your own. There's no way I'm getting involved.
Oh, no worries. Oh, thanks for doing this. You're a marvel.
Governor wants to see her in her office later.
I'll just unload this little
light. No, that can wait for the time being.
Oh, won't take me a minute.
Get moving, Latham. That's an order.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher, you don't want the corridor clogged up with dirty nappies now, do you?
Forget it, Latham. Now, get a move on.